Now, the punk legend, Joe Strummer, the frontman for the hugely influential band The Clash, has died. Strummer, who was 50, was the band's guitarist, vocalist and songwriter. The Clash's third album, London Calling, is still hailed as one of the greatest rock releases ever. It's thought Joe Strummer died of a heart attack. Well, I'm joined in the studio now by the music journalist Chris Salovich. Chris, Joe may not have been a household name, perhaps, in the last few years, but there's no question. I mean, he was a cult figure. He was an icon, wasn't he?
Yeah, he was a huge influence. I think people felt his humanity, because behind that, the anarchic rabble-rouser was a person who was, you know, a sensitive and quite vulnerable poet, and I think people could feel that. And I think there was a multifaceted dimension to him that drew people to him.
Well, I know we've got a clip of The Clash in their heyday, so let's have a quick listen just to remind ourselves of one of their main successes. Still wins prizes for being one of the most popular records of the 80s, doesn't it? I mean, there's no question that Joe Strummer, he was politically very outspoken, wasn't he? He was very left-wing, very anti-Thatcherite, at a time when not many musicians were so politically outspoken.
Well, yes, and he continued to be so, in fact. He was not very fond of the Blair government, and he thought this wasn't a real Labour government. And interestingly, it emerges that Andy Gilchrist was of the Firemen's Union, leader of the Firemen's Union, was politicised by going to see The Clash play the Rock Against Racism show in Hackney in 1978. And only the other week, one of the last shows that Joe Strummer played was a benefit for the Firemen's Union, at which Andy Gilchrist got up and spoke, and it was followed by Joe Strummer playing. And in fact, at that show, Mick Jones, who was his partner in The Clash, and they'd sort of fallen out, although they were friends again, but they'd never played together again. Mick Jones joined him on stage for that show, so I think there's quite a nice poetry about that.
He was definitely a musician's musician as well, wasn't he? I mean, Bono said that he wrote the rule book for U2.
Yeah, well, he certainly did, and I think sort of U2 sort of milked that very well, as a matter of fact. But I think, whereas U2 kept going, you know, and became a huge stadium rock band, I think that was a great problem for Joe Strummer, and perhaps not for all the members of The Clash, but I think he always was troubled by these contradictions. You know, he was the squat rocker, he was the original squat rocker, and I think that, you know, once The Clash became huge worldwide and they had a lot of money, I think this caused him a lot of trouble.
Chris Salovich, thank you very much indeed.
The rock legend Joe Strummer has died of a heart attack at the age of 50. He was lead singer of The Clash, widely regarded as the best of all the punk bands. Among their hits were London Calling, Rock the Casbah and Should I Stay or Should I Go? David Sillitoe looks at the life and music of one of the great voices of rock.
London Calling, see we ain't got no hide.
Joe Strummer, he was the passionate and intelligent voice of punk. The Clash were famous for their energy, their politics, and their part in shaking up the music scene in the 1970s.
Punk really came about because the progressive groups had come to the end of their idea, and music had become very boring. That's really why punk came about.
Of course, the anti-establishment band that once sang, "I'm so bored with the USA," ended up being hugely successful in the States before eventually falling apart. But their influence was huge. The Jam, U2, the Manic Street Preachers all looked to them as a symbol of what music could be. But while the band was linked to the estates of West London, Joe Strummer was educated in Surrey. Born John Mellor, he was the son of a diplomat, but those who knew him didn't doubt either his sincerity about his music or his politics.
It was really the main reason why he was up there on the stage, to get this message across. And I would go out to interview him, and he would insist that I would come back the next day. And sometimes interviews could go on for as long as 3 days before Joe would finally run out of ideas.
Joe Strummer never stopped performing, but he would never recapture what he and his bandmates had found with The Clash. He was intelligent, a musical innovator, but more than anything, a man who proved an exciting band could have a message.
Joe Strummer, who's died of a heart attack at the age of 50, and we're joined by Sir Bob Geldof. Bob, thanks for standing in that very cold field waiting to talk to us. Now, punk music is gone, but Joe Strummer's reputation will live on. Why do you think he was important?
Well, if you think that punk music was important, and I absolutely believe it was, and necessary, it wouldn't have been so important had Joe Strummer not existed. As your report said, he had a clear and palpable intelligence that he lent to the entire attitude. It was an attitude far more than it was a movement or maybe even a music. He lent to it a sort of polemical ability, which it didn't really have with the sort of incoherent nihilism, let's say, of the Pistols or the music itself. And he gave it a sort of political agenda. And he was also able to, in a bizarre way, blend all those socially active forces in Britain in the late 70s when the economy seemed to be running into a brick wall. There was newer waves of immigrants from the West Indies and incorporating their music and indeed the sort of the primal sort of element of that West Indian music into an older rock form which the Clash sort of reinvented and re-energized again. So they were very important musically, but as a person, he was a very nice man, because here we were these bunch of sort of hicks, or at least that's the way they viewed my band, the Boomtown Rats, and it was a very closed London scene, but Johnny Rotten welcomed us, maybe because he was Irish, I guess, but more so Strummer did as well, and we'd sit down and argue a lot, because I found a lot of the sort of attitudinizing a bit much, but he wouldn't let me get away with that. He'd argue and argue. We may not have agreed on a lot, but it was good times. It was good times for that sort of argument. Though having said that, we were intense rivals in terms of trying to sell records and stuff like that. But they were one of the great rock bands, be under no illusion.
What will you miss most about him? Because he's died very young, hasn't he?
His honesty is really a thing that's vitally necessary in pop music, in popular culture indeed, and I'd cite the fact that the Clash actually did believe the things they said when they broke up, and I know for a fact that they were offered huge amounts of money to go on and be one of the sort of giant rock bands, and they declined. And they were offered even greater amounts of money when money was pretty scarce on the ground for Joe and Mick, the guitar player, and the others, and Paul. And they were offered a vast amount, so they just said, no, that isn't really what we stood for. And that is truly admirable. And I bumped into Mick Jones, his sidekick, the one who wrote the songs with him, about 3 days ago, doing Christmas shopping with his daughter. And he was another very nice guy. And, you know, as we all got older and saw each other more and liked each other more, I in turn respected them more retrospectively, simply because they actually did mean what they said. Very rare.
Bob, thank you very much.
Good evening. Now, the music world has been paying tribute to one of the legends of the punk era, Joe Strummer from The Clash. The band's former frontman died of a suspected heart attack yesterday. He was 50. During the late 70s and 80s, Joe Strummer was one of the pioneers of punk. David Sillitoe has been remembering the man and his music.
London calling, see, we ain't got no hide, except for that one with the yellowy eyes.
Whether it was London Calling or Rock the Casbah. Joe Strummer's music was all about passion, politics, and shaking up the 70s music scene.
Punk really came about because the progressive groups had come to the end of their idea, and music had become very boring. That's really why punk came about. The TV and the radio in England at that time switched off at 11 p.m. at night, and also the bars. We were just sitting around after 11 o'clock. Punk was a reaction against a really dull scene.
But rather than the West London estates they sang about, Joe Strummer was born in Turkey, the son of a diplomat, and was educated at a Surrey boarding school. But few doubted his sincerity about either his music or his politics.
He was one of those rare characters, which was a rock and roller who had actually had a brain and was a thinker. And from society's point of view, they're quite movers and shakers.
The Clash split up in the early 80s, but Joe Strummer never stopped performing, and his politics stayed with him. This performance was just a few weeks ago, and it was a benefit concert for striking firefighters.
And I hope the nurses and the teachers and everyone like that comes with you and let's get sensible, you know, and have a proper society.
And despite lucrative offers in recent years, The Clash never reformed.
Joe Strummer, as a singer and a frontman, what he meant and his principles and his songwriting, stands for everything that's sadly lacking in pop these days. So, you know, you're thinking, watching Top of the Pops and thinking, there's got to be more to life than this. There's a lot more to life and a lot more to music than that, and you could do worse than start by listening to The Clash.
Amongst the tributes today were Bono and Bob Geldof, who honoured an intelligent man for whom fame and money were always less important than his music and his politics.
Thoughts on the life of the musician Joe Strummer, who's done